It's no coincidence that the centennial anniversary of the Missouri Highways and Transportation Commission is the same year as the state's bicentennial. Back in 1921, in conjunction with Missouri's 100th year of statehood, the first bipartisan state highway commission was created by the Centennial Road Law in a special legislative session. This law shifted the focus of Missouri highway construction from the local to the state level and created a commission to govern the process. On December 1st of 1921, Governor Arthur M. Hyde appointed four members to the new commission. This commission was empowered to locate, design, construct, and maintain a state highway system. The system was to include approximately 1,500 miles of primary roads and 6,000 miles of secondary roads. The commission could also make the rules governing its own organization, compile highway statistics, prepare plans and make estimates, let all contracts, prescribe uniform highway markings, and purchase or lease land. The State Highway Commission has supervision of highways and bridges, which are constructed, improved, and maintained in whole or in part by the aid of state monies, and of highways constructed in whole or in part by the aid of monies appropriated by the United States government, so far as such supervision is consistent with the acts of Congress relating thereto. Additionally, it provided for the appointment of the positions of Commission Secretary, Chief Engineer, and Chief Counsel. In the 1920s and 30s, the Commission undertook an aggressive road building program that improved the state's highway system called Get Missouri Out of the Mud. As the nation struggled with the Great Depression, the state's highway building efforts slowed, but still made progress through those trying years. In the 1940s, World War II also presented new challenges for the Highway Commission and the state. The normal peacetime economy gave way to an all-out war effort that affected every business in every state of America. Materials were scarce, and the expenditure of every dollar required earnest consideration and careful planning. The Missouri 10-Year Highway Modernization and Expansion Program began in 1952. The department's goal was to incorporate and upgrade 12,000 miles of additional roads to Missouri's farm-to-market highway system. The state relieved the counties of maintenance costs of these roads, providing welcome relief to Missouri's rural communities. At the conclusion of this expansion, the department had exceeded its goal of providing Missourians with a state-maintained road within 2 miles of 95% of all rural family units. Later that decade, the commission would make history again, this time on a national level. On August 2nd of 1956, Missouri became the first state in the nation to begin work on the country's first interstate. The accomplishment came under the provision of the new Federal Aid Highway Program enacted by Congress in June of that year. Three highway construction projects worth over $5 million were undertaken by the department, one on U.S. Route 66 in McLeod County, and the others on U.S. Route 40 in the city of St. Louis and in St. Charles County. The 1960s brought changes of a different kind, with developments to the commission's composition, when a new state law increased the Highway Commission membership from 4 members to 6 in 1965. In the 70s, changes to the commission came in the form of new responsibility. After Missouri voters passed Amendment 2 on November 6 of 1979, the Missouri Highway Department combined with the Department of Transportation to form the Missouri Highways and Transportation Department on January 1st of 1980. This constitutional amendment gave the newly created Highway and Transportation Commission responsibilities in all state transportation programs and facilities. The commission would oversee the final name change for the department in 1996. That's when legislation passed that renamed the agency to the Missouri Department of Transportation. In 2003, the commission enacted the funding allocation formula, which ensured that all Missourians were being fairly served by their Department of Transportation. MoDOT has been recognized for its award-winning planning framework for transportation decision-making. This ongoing process involves MoDOT working with regional planning partners to make sure communities are getting the projects most needed in their areas. Known to citizens of Missouri as MoDOT, the department now oversees 33,830 miles of state-maintained highways and more than 10,000 bridges under the purview of the commission. This year, on its 100th anniversary, the commission still consists of 6 members served by Republicans, Democrats, and Independents. Appointed by the governor, these members serve a six-year term. Since its formation, the commission has had 105 members and 10 commission secretaries. They lead the department through times of prosperity and times of challenge. Working together, these individuals ensure that the state of Missouri is properly served by its Department of Transportation and embody the ideals of safety, service, and stability.